It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mads Maddest Rider, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1591, recorded Thursday, October 6th, 2016. It does nothing! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we get a touch of modern with a portal router and a turn signal jacket. I show off this month's crappy category, and we jump into Interbike, all next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the Same Dumb Show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz, because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the encyclopedia of gadgets. Dick DeBartolo, how you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. It has been a filled week. Can't slow down at all. It's been absolutely fantastic. Last weekend, of course, was our Giz Wiz meetup. And next weekend, I'm on a family vacation.
You were doing an interview. You jumped in the car, flew to New York for the meetup, had a cab waiting. He just ran down to the boat basin.
Exactly.
Spent 2 hours for the meeting, and pretty much, not quite, but left New York City really fast.
I
applaud you for doing that. Oh my gosh.
The interview was I had about 10 minutes after the interview to make sure that I got to the airport. That was about as much time as I had before the next thing. The flight was exactly 2.5 hours after the interview started, and I was able to get on the, or 2.5 hours after it ended. So I had about 30 minutes of wiggle room, but I had to get to the airport, which was about a 20-minute drive. So I had 10 minutes, a full 10 minutes before I started sweating bullets and thinking, oh man, I hope I get to the airport with enough time to do security and everything. But it all worked out.
Good. Good. And also, that was probably one of the times that the flight was on time, right?
Yes. And I tend to fly Southwest, and I don't know what it is about Southwest, but to me, they seem to be on time an awful lot of times. So I'm pretty happy with them. And I think it's because they, you know, most airlines do a hub and spoke sort of situation, and Southwest doesn't do that at all. So a lot of times, if one of your hub cities gets delayed, well, all of your airlines are delayed. Southwest doesn't do that, so I think that's where I had an advantage, and where, or at least Southwest has an advantage for whenever I fly with them. So yeah.
Wow, yeah, I like that when they fly and they say, "Oh, we're going over Chicago. Anybody want to get off here?"
Exactly.
No.
They
we just
very
keep going
laid
to
back.
New York. everybody okay with New York?
Is everybody
right?
Fine with that? Okay, great. We're out. You know what?
Here we go.
We'll give
okay.
you some peanuts and
Yep. Stewardess, go tell the captain that New York is ever fine with everybody.
Don't bounce too hard on the tarmac, otherwise we might get charged. So, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's a good time on Southwest, I feel like.
Oh, great. So do we have a little bit of video that we can show for people who didn't make the meetup?
Yeah, so hopefully this will work out all good. Let me see if I can get rid of
it. We had over 1,000 people watch us on the Periscope feed.
Yes, we did. We had like 1,000 something people watch us do this Periscope feed. Uh-oh.
Hey, always.
I was afraid of that. It's all.
Hey, Chad.
It's all. I was like trying to figure out if I could fix this right before.
Oh, okay.
I got to it, but this was our Periscope feed from the Giz Wiz meetup.
I'm the Giz Wiz.
Oh, can you reverse those cards? Okay. Hey, I'm Dickie Bartolo,
and I'm OMG Chad.
So sorry that it's a little bit crooked, but we had a really good time with the Periscope.
Yeah.
We went down and saw the Hudson. We said hi to everybody.
We saw the new doc.
Becky has been really great.
And
Becky bought little bubble.
You know what we
pies.
Can do, Chad? I just sent you the group photo. We could show that.
Perfect. Perfect. Is that in
because
an email?
That is in landscape. It should be in your email box.
Yeah. That portrait. I was so worried that I was going to cut over to that. It wasn't showing me a thumbnail. That thumbnail looked like it wasn't in portrait. Okay, so here is the group photo from everybody.
The annual group photo. This is the group photo of people who wanted to be in a photo. There were some people who stayed away, and kindly, a lot of people grew mustaches for the event. There it is, and let me see. Even Dennis, non-smiling Dennis holding Charlie, is in the picture.
We all, this was, I mean, it was just so fun this year at the meetup.
There's Josh, our producer, and
yeah.
There's an explorer.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh,
this was
that's
so
right.
Fun.
You had those clip-on glasses.
Yes, yes.
Oh,
Iaz made it out, and Alex, there's Alex.
Alex came in from California.
Becky, there
is let's
Myra.
See, Ranger Rick.
Yes,
Margo and Myra.
This was
it was
a ton of fun.
It was a lot of fun.
And the Boat Basin Cafe is just such a fantastic place. It really is. It's
and Charlie.
Just, yeah, and Charlie. Good old Charlie. He was having a blast. He had a real
blast.
Yeah,
I think we just asked somebody roaming by, can you take a picture? Or maybe it was one of the people. There were a couple of people there who really didn't want to be in the picture.
No, yeah.
So he said, okay, you'll be the photographer.
Yeah, they were the one going, get this camera out of my face. I'm like, okay, put it on me. I'm a camera. I like cameras, so let's do that.
I like, exactly.
So it was so much
right.
fun.
It was fun.
Didn't make it, there's always next year. At the Boat Basin Cafe, and we'd love to have you.
Excellent. Well, we're doing two shows in a row, so let's jump into the first one.
Perfect.
Now, okay? Well, we're going to finish up the Holiday Spectacular, the Pepcom event, and then I'm going to preview one gadget from Interbike at Vegas. So the first is a website I never knew about, but we'll learn about together, called Touch of Tomorrow. Here you go. This is Dick DeBartolo, the Giz Wiz and Mad's Maddest writer. okay, so this little guy is a little robot, and we're going to talk to Ashley here, who is at a website called Touch of Modern. Gifts for men.
Gifts for men, yeah.
So this is a gift for men?
It is a gift for a guy who's really into gadgets and really likes to program things. So you can actually get it to program different things for it to do. So it can kick, it can punch, it can dance, it can do a bunch of different things. So it's definitely the perfect gift for the holiday season for any guy.
Are you connected via Bluetooth?
Connected via Bluetooth, exactly. It's really easy to simply connect, and then you control it on your phone.
And now, what does this guy retail for?
I believe it retails for $299.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's
pretty reasonable.
Yeah, it is pretty reasonable.
Yeah.
And you know what? Let's look at some of the other things on your table. A few of them I know. I know about the keyboard. I know about that guy.
Yeah, so this is Lumade. It's solar.
Lumade, I have.
Cool.
Okay.
These glow headphones, and they glow to the beat of your music. So they'll pulsate to the beat of your own music.
Oh,
so
I like that. Well, what are they called?
Glow headphones.
Glow headphones, and what do they retail for?
I'd have to look it up because okay. I don't have it off the top of my head.
Okay. And what is this weird thing that must cost a lot of money?
Yeah. So this is actually a watch case by Wolf. So it's really for the avid watch collector, the person who has a ton of different watches, and it winds your watches automatically. So if you're wearing an automatic watch, you don't have to like stand up and go, oh, my watch isn't on time. It'll wind your watch for you.
And does it wind it by shaking it?
No, it literally will rotate your watches at a certain time every single day. And you can have it rotate on the hour or every couple of hours. And then this is a collection of some of the best watches sort of available on the market.
Okay, now the watch winder storing device alone costs how much?
It's about $599.
$599, okay. And do you sell those watches too?
We do. All these watches are available.
Okay, we'll just look at one, the most expensive.
Yeah, so the most expensive is the Rolex, and it's a vintage Rolex, and it would retail traditionally for about $18,000. Have it for about $9,000.
Yeah. So, and they're giving one away to every reporter.
Every
it's the most amazing thing in the world.
Everyone can get a watch today.
touchofmodern.com, and this is an ideal website to go to for the holiday season. Ashley, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Okay,
pleasure.
Dennis, grab that watch and run.
Wow, so a very, very, very cool website. You do need an email to sign up.
Yes, you do. And you know, I did call them up because almost everything that I saw in the video is not on the website. And so pretty much they told me for the holiday season what they have on the website soon. The holiday gifts are not up yet. Tend to be on for like a month or so. But the other gadgets, they get very limited amounts of them. Like that, the robot at the very beginning, she said she thought it was 300. Well, everywhere else, it's 400. And I checked a lot of prices, and many times on Touch of Modern, they were less than on Amazon. And they have, gosh, what are you showing? Those things are
neat.
These
are LED lights. I believe that they're 2D, but they look very 3D. I think that this is just a sheet of glass.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
It's great.
Look at that. So that's what it is. That's interesting.
Oh, I see. But if you're looking for an unusual kind of gift, wow, what in the world are those?
This is some sort of a snorkel device where you can kind of see everything because you don't have to, you know, wear a silly little
goggle. I see.
So the snorkel is this. This is the snorkel.
Oh, and it's a full face mask.
Right, exactly.
Wow.
It looks very interesting.
Really interesting, and that's not bad. Was it $69 that I see up there?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, $64.99.
$64, yeah. So it's a very interesting website to check out. And do you know if you got an email back? Because when I registered, I got an email back that said, put this link in Facebook or Twitter or wherever you want, and we'll give anybody who uses that link $10 off. A $10 credit, and we'll give you a $20 credit.
Wow!
So I don't know if everybody gets that when you sign up, but
I didn't check. I didn't look. I need to look.
Oh, okay, to see.
See. Yeah. Wow.
You may have that. So it's touchofmodern.com, and they have very unusual gadgets. And if you see it, like I said. The woman said, normally everything is on sale for just 5 days. But she said, come later this month when we put our Christmas items up, they'll be up for much longer because that's our biggest selling season.
Very cool. Yeah, and I've seen something like this before where it feels almost like a club where you have to sign up and now that you're in, you get all the discount. I've seen stores like Jack Threads is what jumps to mind as a store that does that.
Okay.
But yeah, they have these sort of like flash sales that are up for 5 days
and very nicely curated products.
Yeah. You know, I mean, any of these ties look fantastic. Very cool. So Touch of Modern. Seems like they focus very much on the gadget side of things, which is great.
They do, yeah. They do a ton of gadgets. That little robot, I love that little robot. I like that. What's that? Oh, a phone case. All right. Yeah, no, and the funny thing is I was there right after we taped the spot like 2 weeks ago, and it seems like everything on the website has changed. I don't remember any of those items you're showing. But
right.
It's It's a fun place.
I found the watches. Where's that? Where's that $1,000 watch? $6,000. Wow.
9,000, I think it was.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is $14,000. Normally $42,000.
Oh my gosh.
That's insane.
I hope they have more than one.
Right. What a discount. I must buy five. Wow.
Wow.
So, wow. Yeah. Man, some pretty amazing gadgets to behold at touchofmodern.com.
Touchofmodern.com. And our second gadget, a very interesting gadget. It's called Portal. And why I found it particularly interesting is at a lot of these press events, when you go in, they'll tell you, please turn off the Wi-Fi on your phone and please turn off the Bluetooth on your phone because everybody's using it at the exhibits. And so I go to this place called Portal, and we'll show the video and then talk about it. So video two from Pepper. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz here at PepCom, and this is their holiday edition. So there's a lot of neat stuff here with the neat, and we're looking at Portal. So when we come to these events, there's always a shortness of Wi-Fi. No one can get Wi-Fi because everybody's using it, but Vinit tells me that monitor there is tell me what's on that monitor.
So on that monitor, we're showing three 4K videos. We're also running a demo video. And we also can run speed tests. We can run videos on the iPads all concurrently in this PepCom show where there's too much crowded Wi-Fi.
And we're doing this wirelessly.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Completely wireless.
Okay. So can we see what the signal is coming from?
Yes. So
Let's go over here, and...
So why don't we do this so it's easy okay. for you guys. So here, if you see, this is the Wi-Fi Analyzer app. It's a very popular Android app. This is showing actually all the Wi-Fi signal around here, around PepCom. But if you notice here, this is Portal. It's completely in a clean channel. There's not that many people around it. What you see around it are some very expensive, hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of routers. We're bringing that to the consumer level. This will be available for $199, this shipping now.
All right, so let's take a look at what the Portal unit looks like. And we have one right here.
So right here within this unit are 9 antennas. They're distributed all around the edge of the frame. On the back, we have a WAN port. We have 4 LAN ports and 2 USB ports.
Wow. Now, and you said this is coming soon?
It's shipping next week. And we have a wonderful Kickstarter community. And so we're shipping to Kickstarter community. And then we'll be on Amazon here shortly.
Okay. And your website is?
PortalWiFi.com.
PortalWiFi.com. Under $200. That's our first find here at PepCom 2016 Holiday Edition. Dickie Bartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv.
So this is amazing because I've seen Wi-Fi hotspots that use extra antennas, that use beamforming and all that, but they tend to cost really like a lot of money. I've seen commercial Wi-Fi even that costs like tens of thousands.
Yeah, well, you know what the secret is? Actually, if you can go to Amazon, I have an Amazon link in my notes? Okay, there, and just start that video about 40 seconds in. And you can see their secret, which is very, very clever.
You'll get a much more reliable.
There you go. That's perfect.
Imagine, if you will, a 6-lane freeway. But for the last 15 years, everybody's really only driven on one lane, or maybe two if you're lucky. You ask yourself, why are these 4 lanes not being used? Well, we've solved that problem. Portal uses all of those lanes, and it does it intelligently. We can change lanes predictably to avoid interference and to avoid traffic.
A big part of the Wi-Fi spectrum actually is reserved for radar. Wi-Fi is allowed to share on it, but
to share it, you have to make sure radar is not present. And that's a very delicate and very highly regulated environment. We've received certification for doing that. The way we achieve that is we've been working with the FCC for quite some time. All of our products are now authorized to work within those radar bands. So one of the key applications we developed Portal for was gaming. What we wanted to do is create some special channels that offered both high bandwidth and very low latency. And we control the access to those channels so that if we know you're gaming and we can detect that automatically, we'll give you the best gaming experience possible.
There's no other router in the world that can do what we do.
This is the solution. We think we can change Wi-Fi forever.
Interesting. Interesting.
Yeah, so you could use the radar channels as long as you don't create any sort of interference.
Interesting.
So they have come up with a way that it knows how much of the radar channels they can go on, assuming that no one else or no radar is using them. So huh. It seems wildly sophisticated to me.
It does. It scares me, though, because you would think that it was built into the Wi-Fi spec that if you're going to use those channels, that you would stay at a certain spectrum and people would still be... That seems... That radar claim seems very fishy to me.
Okay.
Knowing how specific Wi-Fi spec is, and knowing... I've never heard of that before, and that it seems very, very fishy, but they worked with the FCC.
Well, you know
so what?
What
can you say? I mean...
We'll find out.
Yeah.
Actually, when they become available, they said, do you want to try one? And
now, the fast... So there are many channels on Wi-Fi. There's, in fact, I believe, if I'm remembering correctly, 11 channels on Wi-Fi. And many routers are automatically set up just to use the first channel. And so you do, that is an issue. I've just never heard of this, of the radar thing before. And there's even some channels that are specifically for other countries. Like, I believe Channel 11 is normally reserved for Japan. And so I do believe that the channel switching is very smart, because if you get congestion on a certain band, you know, there's only so many times that a router can search for packets on that band. So it's good. PC guys, people are saying, a few of the things I'm saying, you know, 1, 6, and 11, but you're supposed to use 3, people are saying, yeah. So I've heard of this channel thing in Wi-Fi many times. And okay. In fact, if you go into your Wi-Fi settings, you can you can switch the channel. So intelligent channel switching, that sounds great. Absolutely great. So interesting. Very, very cool. So it's a $200 Wi-Fi router with intelligent channel switching and possibly radar avoidance, which is...
Yes, possibly, yeah. And while you're using your Wi-Fi, if a cop pulls you over, you know that your router has gone into the wrong lane.
Exactly. That was the HOV lane. Sorry, you weren't allowed to be in that lane. Yeah, very cool. I you know what? A better Wi-Fi is never going to make me sad. So if they can figure it out, good, more power to them.
Exactly. So that's my last. I saw the show in reverse order because in the video I said we're going to look around some more. So that was actually the first thing I saw at Pepcom. But we're finishing up Pepcom, and we're starting with Interbike. Interbike, a show about every conceivable kind of bike, electric bikes, folding bikes, and every kind of bike accessory. And we're going to start out with a really clever one that we saw a prototype years ago, but now it's at a very reasonable price and it's for sale. So let's watch that.
Okay.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. If this looks familiar, I think we showed it a couple years ago. It was like a prototype. Well, now it's in the marketplace, and we're going to talk to Gary, who's over here, follow the bouncing lights. Gary, how you doing?
Hi, how you doing?
Good to see you. So, Gary, this is on the marketplace now. And I think when it first came out, it was going to be like hundreds of dollars. What does this retail for?
It's saying $85 now.
$85. This is a great way to be noticed. You know, I didn't even look. Am I lit in the back?
You certainly are.
Okay.
Also, lift your arm up and look. People can see what you're doing from behind
That's
as well.
Great.
Either arm. Put your helm back down, and it continues to indicate for 5 seconds, and it'll turn off eventually. There you go. Perfect safety.
This is really great. Now, looking ahead, there's going to be something new for 2017. Can you show us that?
There certainly is. We're actually bringing in a photovoltaic technology where the jacket will actually light up automatically. So I've just covered the sensor so you can see it's happening. And by covering that up, the lights have decided, there you go. Unfortunately, the jacket actually goes to sleep as well. So if you stand still for a period of time, it turns itself off. There you go. So it turns on.
Okay, and then this will have the sleeves. It's not hooked up right now, but it'll also have the turn sleeves. 2017, any idea what the price might be?
In the region of $150.
Okay. Pounds and dollars about equal now?
Don't be like that.
Okay. Touchy subject, okay. Dick.
And the website, visitjax.com? It's super at the bottom of the screen. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medist writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. He went that way. Bye.
That very flashy gadget there. Very, very flashy gadget.
Yeah, yes.
That's really cool. I like it.
23 LEDs, and as you saw when you put your arm up, it signals both sides of your arm. So people in the back of you, obviously you want them to see it, but people in the front, if you have pedestrians, they can see which way you're turning. And then when you put your arm down, between 5 and 10 seconds, the turn signal shuts off. But the little red lights on your jacket blink all the time. It's a little battery pack, and you charge it, and I think it ran for 20 hours on a full charge.
That
so
is
it's a
way
great
cool.
Yeah.
I think this is great because I've seen plenty of bicyclists with that one single LED on the back of their bike. And if it's dark, even your car's headlights are made to point down and not where a turn signal might be able to be seen, especially at night. So that's, I'm sold. I think if you biked avidly and had $83 to spend, absolutely. Absolutely. And it comes in black and bright yellow.
Yellow, yeah. And it's Visijax, yeah. Amazon or at the company website.
Yeah, absolutely. Comes all the way up to XXL. Let's see, Amazon reviews, they all seem pretty good. There's only 12 of them. But, wow, I think that I remember seeing this way back in the day, and it was definitely very prototype-like. But this is
yes, exactly,
fantastic.
And wildly expensive. But
yes.
Now for 80, yeah, I'm looking on Amazon there, $83 in free shipping, not Amazon Prime, but that is, you will be seen.
Yeah. Nick with a C in the chat room says, why do they make a black version? And then internal analysis, because black equals cool. It does seem a little bit counterintuitive. To have a black version when you want to be seen, but I think it looks really, really nice as well.
Pretty good.
Visa Jax. Very nice, very nice. Cool. Well.
And now, is it time, ladies and gentlemen? I have no idea. This is our first show of October. Go ahead, let the theme run.
Hopefully it'll run. It sometimes takes a little while. In fact, I don't even know if this program launched correctly. Oh gosh, there it is. Okay, we may need to sing it ourselves for this crappy corner. But yes, it is the start of the month. Here, before we play the tune, do you want to see what the patrons said?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, before we get to the tune, here are the results. This is the straw poll voted by the patrons, and the results are in. With over 59%, it is driving gadgets. I thought selfie gadgets was a winner. Nobody cared. We only got 3 votes for selfie gadgets.
Oh, yeah.
I thought that was going to be the best. I thought that was going to drive away with it. But sure enough, driving gadgets is the winner. So with that...
You know you don't need it, but you might want it at Chad's Crafty Corner. Get it.
Okay.
All right.
So, driving this month's driving gadgets. And I kind of wanted to do something different for this month as well. And just for this week, actually. And that is to go find something that was the cheapest that I could possibly buy. And so I went to, have you ever been to the Dollar Tree, Dickie D?
We don't have one, but I went to the one in Petaluma.
Oh, yeah. So it's a dollar. Everything is a dollar.
Yeah.
At the Dollar Tree.
I wish I had one here.
So I have a few choice selections from the Dollar Tree of my crappy gadgets. So first off, you're driving in your car. You have that the great dome light. What happens if the light goes out? You're not going to exchange the bulb. You're going to get a whole new dome light, of course. So this is a portable a portable lamp. Very, very easy to install. You have a removable plate on the bottom that you can either slide off. You got that 3M sticky stuff. Or it comes with screws. Wouldn't you want to screw this into the top of your car? And then it comes with a very convenient pull tab. Look at how bright that is.
Oh my God.
Whenever you have an idea or two, you just
Oh
my gosh. Yes. There we go. That's the best idea I've had all day. It's here.
You know, I think Leo Laporte is going to want that for his Tesla.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, you can't ever have enough light in your car. So here we go. We'll shut off the studio lights, and you can just see how bright this is. Oh my gosh!
Wow, blinded.
So great. And on top of that, it has swiveling action built in, so you can, if you attach it to the top of your car here, you can swivel it whichever way you want, Dick. This is just the best gadget. Okay, but we didn't stop there, don't worry.
And was it 2 double A's?
It is 3 triple A's, which were not included. So,
no, I would, for a buck, I would think not. Okay.
Not included. Okay. That was my first bright idea for a car gadget. Next, you're rolling down the street and your stereo goes out. Well, what are you going to do? You're not going to replace that stereo. You're going to pull out your new mini stereo speaker right here. It's shaped like a classic boombox. There we go.
Okay.
And it works as simply as, remember that headphone jack that's on every iPhone? Well, sorry.
It used to be.
Yeah. Okay, you plug it right in.
I bet for a buck this has some amazing sound.
I need to find a Giz Wiz theme here to play. I guess I didn't come prepared. We might, here we go.
What kind of batteries is in there? That is
none.
So tiny.
This is just, it's just a speaker, Dick. It's, it's just
okay.
That simple, you understand. Actually, this is quite stylish. You could set it down and you got the tunes just, sitting right there. Let's see if I have any, of, the Giz Wiz. Nope. It doesn't look like there's any Giz Wiz music in my library. Let's play something that I know that no one's going to get mad at me.
Yeah, I know. We always have that problem.
There we go. Jonathan Colton. Whoops. That did not work. Jonathan Colton. Okay, here we go. That did not at all get Jonathan Colton. Here we go. There we are. Okay, let's play. There we go. This re your brains. Prepare yourself. Oh my gosh, can't play anything. This is a song by DJ Z, which is a big friend of the show. I can't. I don't think it's actually coming out. Oh, it is.
Wow. Wow.
Wow. Okay, so here it is with the iPhone speaker.
I think it sounds better with the iPhone speaker.
Here it is with the new speaker. So much better. Okay, iPhone speaker. I don't.
It's way better with the iPhone speaker, isn't it?
It is. It is. I wish you were here in person because it's so pathetic. It's so pathetic. The iPhone speaker is worlds better than this mini speaker radio. Okay, well, that may not have been worth the whole dollar that it cost to. But this next gadget, we've all seen them. These are these window decals that are amazing. You put them on the back of your car. So here we go. We'll test one out. Oh, watch out, Dick! Here comes a baseball! Oh no! Oh, it's
what is it? I see it. Okay, I got it.
Here comes a golf ball. I don't know about the dollar store run. This may be a segment that will not last on the Giz Wiz. I think this idea was not the brightest idea I've ever had.
So there's $3 of the Giz Wiz budget down the drain.
I'm sorry, Dick. I don't know how to apologize profusely enough. It looks like our screen here is getting cracked. This was, I think, the worst Giz Wiz gadget I've ever purchased. Well, it's called Crappy Corner for a reason. It's not Fancy Corner or Good Corner. So those were a few gadgets at the Dollar Tree for a car. Here, I can pull off the decals here.
Ow, ow, ow.
They peel quite nicely right off. These might even be great Halloween decals for you. It's stuck. It's stuck forever. There we go.
Oh, okay. Good.
So, with that, let's jump into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Oh, you know what I didn't play? Is the...
You didn't play the video.
The video! Oh, man, I got so tied up in the... in the Dollar Tree amazement of my Dollar Tree purchases.
Oh, that's all right. It'll come back on the next show.
Exactly. Okay.
Okay, so we have a viewer video, a complaining viewer video. Hi, Dick and Chad. This is Kit Ron. I decided to make a review today about the bug bulb that was shown on the Giz Wiz. The Above Edge Pest Blast 2-in-1 Ultimate Killer, Ultimate Mosquito Killer, and Pest Control. Amazon just, they have these endless names. Pest Control Energy Efficient LED Light Bulb. Since the company that makes them didn't even bother to respond to me, I made a complaint to Amazon and a refund is in the works. So here is the review, Kitron, and he says one word we normally don't have. We'll try to mute it. So here's Kitron's succinct review.
Perfect.
Good morning, Chad and Dick. I wanted to do a review today for the bug bulb that was shown on the Giz Wiz. Unfortunately, 2 months ago, it fell out of its socket and could easily catch my house on fire. So here's my honest review on this thing today. It's a piece I'm going to be honest about this. I hope nobody ever buys something like this. On a side note, could I get a magazine for this review, for my honest review? I would really appreciate it. Thanks. Kiss along.
Okay, that All bug right. bulb. Oh, man. A crummy gadget.
Okay, so now,
gadget.
Let me show you mine.
Okay.
So mine, you can, you know, it used to light up a bright blue.
And is now, that on? Is it on?
That is on.
Oh, no.
Right. So when, you can see, it only lights at the top. And mosquitoes, I think, just use it as a nightlight. So the main part of the bulb still works, okay? So
okay.
It goes bright. But the bug part, and so when I got a letter from Amazon saying these lights are defective, please call this number for a replacement. I was trying to get my money back. I called for days, and I finally got through to them, and they said, what's the exact name that Amazon has on your order? And I said, it is the Above Edge. And they said, stop there. It's not ours. She said, the bulb we sell is not unique to us. And what she meant by that is if you go to Amazon.
We resell a bunch of these things.
This same bulb is on Amazon under like 13 different names. So it turns out I believe that Kitron had one of the defective ones because they literally fall apart. And she said, so we can't do anything for you. You just have to keep the bulb you have. So, you know, it's 3 months old. So, and I'm not going to bother returning it because what is Amazon gives you 30 days, right?
Yeah.
But I mean, it is a piece of crap. It almost is like they painted it so that it looked blue, like a killing blue. But it doesn't work at all. There's more like what it should look like. Oh, wow, there's the inside of it.
Wow.
Now, I can still save it as kind of a light bulb, but it's not worth it. So I would probably avoid this under any name. But that's what's happening. They're coming apart.
Oh, my gosh. And poor, it happened to poor Kithron, too. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, and good. I mean, he was smart to go right to Amazon and get his money back.
Right. Don't bother with the manufacturer. Wow. What a piece of crap. This is the perfect
piece of crap. And
Kitron,
you'll get a magazine for that. So we're looking for more videos. Something you bought and hated, like that bulb. Something that you have around the house and you just can't throw it out. Just make a video, 2 to 3 minutes, put it on YouTube as unlisted, so that just people with the link can watch it, and send it to mail@gizwiz.tv. And if you use it on the show, you'll get an autographed copy of Mad Magazine and a 32-year-old Alfred E. Newman picture, which we will send both those to Kitron. And there you go. We need more videos, so do it soon.
Perfect. Get your crappy gadgets over to us. And with that, it is time for the letter. Through this nice speaker system I got, Dick.
Here come the Giz Wiz letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters.
Okay, our letter of the week is the shortest email we got, but one of the most interesting. This is the entire email. It's from David Eckhart, E-C-K-A-R-D. And he writes, this is right up your gadget alley. Okay, now before you go to the link, Chad, I'm going to tell you what it is.
Okay.
It is a tiny little hand toy, a one-inch cube for people who fidget. So one side of it has a little toggle switch. One side has an on-off button. One side has digits that you can move the digits around. Now, this company, it's Kickstarter, and that's where we're going to go when you click the link. They were looking for $15,000.
Okay.
So, chat room can play along. What do you think they are up to now for this little gadget that will sell for $20?
Okay, and an object that does nothing other than allow you to fidget. And it sells for $20.
Yeah, right now you can get $19.
Seems up the alley of most internet aficionados. They like to fidget, ADD, very ADD.
Yes, okay.
Asking price was what again?
They were looking for $15,000.
I'd say $2 million.
Okay, let's go to that link and see how much they're up to.
What? $5.6 million for a cube that does nothing?
Is this the most unbelievable?
Why have we not kickstarted some ridiculous gadget?
You know,
it doesn't
do
anything.
I know. You know, we could do this on an ice cube, and we could call it the air conditioning fidget cube.
Wow! I got it.
I just fidget.
I just fidget all the time. This is my problem, I fidget.
Pop.
Okay.
Let me give our friends and coworkers.
Well, let me see the cube.
Situation. From a class.
There it is.
To a boardroom. The fidget cube, of course, has six sides.
Is it like a dice where this is five on one and one on... No, it doesn't do that. The glide, a joystick that... across the surface. What? Oh my gosh.
Yeah, just an on-off switch.
They have a molded part that all you do is you just rub your finger around the molded part. It doesn't even switch. It doesn't even have anything.
Yes. I think the gears move, and the little toggle switch just goes on off.
Honky in the chat is trying to defend this as it has really pushy buttons. They're really clicky push buttons. There's no way these people. This is probably a team of like three guys at most. Two. There they are. There's two guys. These guys are millionaires. Millionaires. They have just made millions of dollars. You could split that amongst both of them, and they would both have $2.5 million.
And enough money left over to make the fidget cube.
This is a product that they're going to go to China and make for like a dollar at most. At most. And they're selling it for $20?
To write, isn't it? David Eckhart, thank you. I could not believe it when I clicked on. I was thinking, like some people in the chat room, I was thinking $1 million. More than $5.5 million. That's more than our Patreon members are paying.
That's more than I think money has ever passed through my hands during my entire and your lifetime combined.
Yeah, no.
Whoa. I know it's not all profit. I know Kickstarter's going to take a cut. I know creating... Now, they have to create 136,000 of these fidget cubes. But
there's still going to be a nice little bit of money left.
Yeah.
Over.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Well, what can you say? There's 13 days to back the project. If you need to purchase a fidget cube, you can. I will be abstaining from buying a fidget cube, but
no, I think so.
I hope that
like
everyone
some in
buys
the chat room like it. Yeah,
buys
like
the Giz Wiz's ice cube, which will be hitting Kickstarter any moment now.
Yeah.
For those who have very warm hands, the ice cube is the perfect fidget device.
And you'll get a tray of 12 of them.
Yeah, it's biodegradable as well. It's great for the environment.
And you can produce your own fidget cubes at will.
Yeah. That was it's a good letter. Good letter. I was shocked. I thought 2 million was a little bit far out. Thanks, David, for showing that to us.
Wow.
You know, I think if you're frustrated that those guys are millionaires over a one-inch cube that does absolutely nothing, maybe take your frustration out on our Patreon page by supporting us. That's kind of a long shot. I don't know if that's going to work. We have a Patreon page, patreon.com/GizWiz. Patreon is a site that supports independent content creators by letting people pledge recurring payments for support. It works perfectly for podcasts, because here we are making a podcast every single week for you guys. Thank you so, so, so much to all of our patrons for your support. It's just absolutely fantastic that we can rely on our audience as we do. It's really heartwarming. Thank you guys so much for your support. Thank you so much for your generosity so far. It's been, it's awesome. It's just absolutely fantastic. So thank you guys so, 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 so much. And just want you guys to know that it's there to support patreon.com/GizWiz. Don't forget, you can watch the show live when we are on schedule. Next week's show is canceled because we are recording another one right after this. And then the week after that will be recorded on Monday instead of Thursday because I will be gone again. Sorry, everyone. If you don't want to watch the show live, don't worry. We record it for you and we put it online. Gizwiz.tv is the place to go. You can go to all of our past episodes, and once you're there, you can click on either a link to go buy the item we talked about, or you could click on the name of the item and see a write-up from Dickie D himself at gizwiz.biz, which is absolutely fantastic. Hey, while you're there at gizwiz.biz, why not play What the Heck Is It? It's the game where you gotta guess what the gadget is. It's like Dick's Gadget Warehouse in reverse, where you see the item but aren't told what it is, and you have to guess it. So this week it's obviously the prototype of the very first puppets ever made. This was before they learned to put eyes and mouths on the puppets. If you think that you have a better guess, get on over to gizwiz.biz, click on What the Heck Is It, and send your guesses in. There's 12 Mad Magazines, and here they are for the correct answers, but 24 Double the Mad Magazines for cute, funny, hilarious, silly, and ridiculous answers. I guess that wraps it up for this episode. We don't have the Boat Basin Cafe to talk about anymore. Not until next year.
We don't.
So we will see you guys on the next episode of the Giz Wiz.
I'll be here.